Millions of people have lost weight with personalized plans from Noom, like Evan, who can't stand salads and still lost 50 pounds.
Salads generally for most people are the easy button, right? For me, that wasn't an option. I never really was a salad guy. That's just not who I am. But Noom worked for me.
Get your personalized plan today at Noom.com. Real Noom user compensated to provide their story. In 4 weeks, the typical Noom user can expect to lose 1 to 2 pounds per week. Individual results may vary.
SRBMedia.com.
Welcome to this week's Made in Brum, and on this week's show we will be joined by Christopher, Stuart, John and Nick from Birmingham band Paper Buoys. But kicking the show off this week is my track of the week by the band The Rebel Divide called Nowhere to Ride. Was The Rebel Divide with a track called Nowhere to Ride, and thanks to John Lee and Andy Bean for getting in touch. Shortly, we'll be joined on the show by the band Paper Buoys, and a big thank you to the band Lobster for making me aware of today's guests, and the first track I ever heard from the Paper Buoys was this next one. This is one of my favourites called Sharp as Razors. Just heard the brilliant Paper Boys, and I'm very pleased that we've got Chris and John with us. We're still waiting for the other guys, but welcome, guys.
Hello.
Hello.
Your track, Sharp as Razors, absolutely love that video for that.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
You must be proud of that, because it's very distinctive and very unusual, the video.
Yeah, absolutely. It was made by a guy that we know. We'd seen a couple of videos he'd done for another local band who were called And You and I. He'd done a couple of kind of animated videos. It's kind of his style. He's also done a video for The Prodigy, and just after seeing those, we just knew we needed to do a video with him. So, Sharp as Razors, check it out on YouTube.
Which area of Birmingham are the band from?
Originally, we all grew up round, like, Sutton Coldfield area. We've all kind of separated a bit now, haven't we?
Yeah, we've scattered across Birmingham a little bit now.
And how long have the band been going?
We started Paper Boys probably January, February this year. We've played together for a lot longer.
We've been playing for a few years in other bands and stuff.
Are you pleased the way things have been going for the band?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, like I say, we put out a couple of good videos, and that's kind of helped us along the way, because people have picked up on it, and it's been quite exciting so far.
How would you describe the musical style of the band?
Tricky one.
It's always difficult to describe your own music. But,
yeah.
Loosely, it's indie rock. A lot of people have said it's got a punk kind of style to it. That's how I would describe it.
Well, let's have another track from your band. Let's go with your debut single, Fun.
One song.
The debut single by the Paper Buoys, and the video was filmed in a very familiar place, Chris.
Yeah, that's right, Birmingham on Sea.
Sunny Western.
Sunny Western Supermare, yeah. That was filmed, I think it was January or February.
Early February.
Yeah, it was pretty cold. I mean, the whole idea, because the song's called Fun, and the idea of the video was to go and do something that might not be. Being in a fun place in the winter, in the freezing cold, and, you know.
Well, one of the amazing things of the video is they've actually got the sea.
It looks pretty grim anyway.
Yeah, I'm not sure you want it. Like. But the video's great, really good. And cool. You were there for a while, Chris. You actually lived in Western.
Yeah, I lived in Western for a year when I was at college. And that was where we met our good friend Slim Jim, who recorded the video for us, as he lives there. And
well, we're now joined by Nick and Stuart from the band, who've managed to get through the terrible traffic outside.
Yeah.
Welcome, guys.
All right, thank you. How's it going, Dave? Yeah.
Well, I'm going to ask you a question now on Birmingham's current music scene.
Well, I think it's good. I think it's saturated, but that's a good thing. Lots of good bands, lots of different genres. But then, saying that, they've got the venues for it, and, you know, people seem to be going to see live bands, so generally it's pretty good.
Right. I think the current crop of Birmingham bands out there is exceptional. There's so much talent out there. Bands like yourself, Lobster, Little Liam, Sam Rogers, so much talent. I mean, I just think it's fantastic. I mean, I've gone to gigs at the Sunflower Lounge, the Rainbow, the Actress and Bishop, and every band I've seen has just been exceptional. We're getting a few bands breakthrough, like Broken With Rebels. It needs more. And
agreed.
They are really, really good out there. Which brings us on to your choice of Birmingham bands that you've chose for us. Do you want to introduce this band?
Yeah, the first band we've chose is Lobster. We've been a fan of Lobster for a long time. They can get anybody going because there's rock, reggae, ska, punk, all in it. So,
what track have you chosen?
The new track's Art Cut Blues.
Performing jesters, pennies from investors, give them 95%. The finest wine, money well spent. Slashing like Wolverine, chewed up by the mean machine. Slashing like Wolverine, chewed up by the mean machine. We got no way to choose. We got that Arca Blues. We got no way to choose. We got that Arca Blues.
imagination, salvation, creation, damnation. Washed up by a sea of blue, tsunami, the home of the youth. And they take it away, let my take it away. 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 It's just the same old blues. We got the hope, we got that alcohol. It's just the same old blues. We got the hope, we got that alcohol. It's just the same old blues. We got the hope, we got that alcohol. It's just the same old blues. We got the hope, we got that alcohol. In a punk reggae style, still step up on the place and get the people going wild. You're doing sweat for rubber dub since 2009. Put in a lot of work, we've done this for a long time. You know it's Midlands music that I'm playing every day. That love for my scene, it hasn't gone away. So much passion showing in the tunes that we play. DIY rum sounds in a dig buff today. Big up the stiff joints, the crack that does my luck. The culture friendly fire, GBH, Mr. Shank. Brassic, Dantana, Gusensi, too spicy. Every single member of the PSD family. Who's that on the decks? It's Robin and I'm Flo. Big up Jam Jam Sound and the Sexy Widows. Big up Jam Tidy, Big up Boys, Kyoko. We miss Generic, Eric and Incredito.
Never be.
Welcome back to part two of Made in Brum, and you've just heard the Cult Collective with a track called Here Come the Cynics. Great choice, Chris.
Thank you very much. I had to play it because I've worked up that many times with that chorus in my head. I think it's just a big tune, so shout out to the Cult Collective.
Where are the band from?
I think they're from over towards like Edgbaston, Bearwood kind of way. I'm not entirely
Smedic,
sure.
Smedic is it? From, yeah. From my patch, yeah.
And have they been going long?
Not too long, no. Probably about the same amount of time as us, really. About this year, really, they've started to put tracks out.
10 months, you know, 10 months to a year.
So apart from the Cult Collective, Lobster, are there any other new Birmingham bands out there that you really like at the moment?
Yeah, there's lots. We've chose a few today. Mainly the people that we've come across to on the scene, we've gigged with, we just know from about, from pubs, from open mics and stuff. And we really like Rob Craig Alton, solo artist, but he plays with a band. He just brought out an EP called April Showers, really good. And our mates that go way back, the Terawatts, really good band,
fun band. Yeah, really good band, Terawatts.
And we've known them for years, so yeah.
Well, let's go back to the end of last year. Yeah, you released your latest single, After Dark. Brilliant track. Love the video. Talk to us about the video, because the video is interesting. And where did you film it?
Yeah, well, we basically got back in touch with Oliver Jones, who did the video for Sharp as Razors, and obviously wanted to, work with him again. And he put us in touch with a good friend of his, Brandon Kahn. And, we wanted to do something a bit different and... something a bit sort of a bit gritty, a bit like edgy. So we actually filmed it the sort of back streets of Birmingham, not too far from our studio, like the sort of gun quarter of Birmingham.
Yeah.
I mean, that went on pretty much all night, that recording. I don't think we left till about 3 a.m, did we?
Mm-hmm. It was freezing cold.
Yeah, it was.
Well, I'll tell you what, I think it's a great track. Should we listen to it? This is the track, After Dark. And obviously that was released towards the end of 2016. Are there any plans for an EP or album in 2017?
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, we've put a few singles out because we wanted to get the name of the band out a bit, but now we're ready to release something, probably an EP or a mini album. It's going to be soon. We've recorded all the tracks at Magic Garden Studio with Gavin Monaghan, so we're just finalising which tracks are going to go out on the EP now. So
let's go on to your next Birmingham band choice. Who wants to introduce this?
Yeah, this is a tune called Too Real, and it's by the Terawatts.
That was a great choice. Really enjoy the Terawatts. I think they're an absolutely brilliant band.
Yeah, brilliant band. Love the Terawatts.
Have you played with the Terawatts?
No, we haven't played with the Terawatts, but we've played with them in previous bands when they were the Cedar House band. But we know I've been to see them lots of times. Yeah, they're great.
Well, we're going to play another track by your band, and this is an exclusive because this hasn't been released. And
no.
Is this the demo you've got for us?
No, yeah, it's the finished. Track that should be on the EP. Most likely will be on the EP.
Do you want to introduce it then, Stuart?
Yeah, this is Break Down the Wall.
I'm not afraid to die.
We're going to be taking a short break now, but playing us into that break is a band called The Brazen. This is a great track called Get High.
Thank you. It's only a game. It's only a game. It's only a...
Welcome back to part three of Made in Brum, and you've just heard an exclusive track by the Birmingham band Paper Buoys. The track is called Headshot, which is unreleased. So let's talk about this Fred Perry subculture list that you've been added to of the yep. best Birmingham bands. This was last year in 2016. Yep. That must be a massive honour to be included in that.
Yeah, yeah. Some of the bands in there, especially Youth Man and Kyoko. Yeah, it's really, really good to be involved in that.
Yeah, well, there's the Cut Glass Kings as well, The Assist, Last Light, Hand Wax and Sugar Thieves.
Yeah.
I mean, last year, the 8th of December, you played with the Cut Glass Kings at the Victoria.
Yeah.
How did that gig go?
It was good. Yeah, it was really good. Yeah, it was a really good gig because there wasn't like any pressure on us because we didn't have a lot of people come down because it's a last minute thing.
Well, we only got asked to play.
We only got asked to play the day before.
Barely had enough time to write a set list.
Well, let's go on to another Birmingham band's choice. Which one are you going for?
We're going for a guy called Tom Walker.
He's a great artist.
Brilliant guitar player, brilliant songwriter, brilliant singer. Plays with Dino and Jim. They used to play Brothers Groove, brilliant band.
What track are you going with?
It's called Human Nature. Stop
human nature bring you down, all have to face it sooner or later, all stand together.
And you've just heard the fantastic Tom Walker. Well, we're going to throw a question in the mix now. This is going to cause a bit of a debate. So, as a band, what would you consider the best decade for Birmingham music?
That's a tough question.
That's a good one. Well, obviously, yeah. You know, you've got...
I think there's a few standout eras, really. There's obviously the obvious things like the birth of metal. Black Sabbath.
Your late 60s, early 70s sort of metal.
That was a very important time for music, obviously, yeah. Sabbath. You got Zeppelin.
Yeah.
And then you've got the reggae steel pulse.
The beat.
So that's a tough question. I would say 60s or... It would be 60s or 80s, wouldn't it?
Yeah, well, that's what I would go for. Yeah. I mean, I love the 60s Brum-Beat era and I love... that rock that was inspired by the Mothers Club in Irvington.
Yeah.
I love the 80s stuff where we had Dexys and Duran Duran and UB40 and all that kind of rum-runner scene come through because I was, obviously, I knew it pretty well. I totally agree with you. To me, it's either got to be the 60s or 80s. There was a lot of good bands in the 90s, like Ocean Colour Scene as well.
Ocean Colour Scene, yeah. We like Ocean Colour Scene.
We like them, yeah. Yeah.
Well, let's ask you your musical influence on the band. If you could choose one artist as maybe an icon or somebody you really like, who would you go with?
Yeah, it's a very difficult question for us to answer as a band, I think, because we've all got very different influences. But I'm going to choose a song because I've stepped up to the mic.
go on.
Yeah, and it's a good tune. It's an excuse to play a tune. So Bob Dylan. Bob Dylan kind of, I suppose, really influenced me to start writing lyrics when I was 16, 17. I really got into Bob Dylan, especially his early stuff. So
what track are we going to play out of the show with them, Chris?
Subterranean Homesick Blues.
Well, thanks to join us on this week's show. Really enjoyed it. Had a great laugh. So thanks, lads.
Thanks for having
Best
us.
Best of luck.
Thank you.
Best of luck with your EP in 2017. I hope it really goes well. And this is Bob Dylan.
John is in a basement mixing up the medicine. I'm on a pavement thinking about the government. A man in a trench coat, batch out laid off. Says he's got a bad cough, wants to get it paid off. Took out a tin, it's something you did. God knows when, but you're doing it again. You better duck down the alleyway looking for a new friend. Maggie comes fleet foot, face full of black soot, top
short pants, romance. Learn to dance, get dressed, get blessed. Tired of his success. Please her, please him. Buy gifts, don't steal, don't risk. 20 years of schooling and he put you on a day shift. Look out, kid, they keep it all hid. Better jump down a manhole, light yourself a candle. Don't wear sandals, try to forge a scandal. Don't want to be a bum, you better chew gum. The pump don't work cause the vandals took the handle.
Thanks to the Paper Boys for being this week's guest. And we was meaning to play this track earlier, but unfortunately we had a bit of a problem with the system, so apologies to the lads. This is Robert Craig Alton with a fantastic track called April Showers.
Just what I wanted. Tell me my dreams are haunted. What the doctor ordered, I need you to bring me forward. Out of this state showers and I'm good. Stand over me like a tower, keep away the April showers and I'm good.
That was Robert Craig Alton. Fantastic track. And just as I was leaving, one of our familiar faces on the show, Louise Woodley, has just turned up.
Hello, hello. Louise.
Yeah, you've just turned up because we're going to do another recording after this.
Yes.
So we've got another interview to do. So we were talking on the phone about this local band, Towson.
Yeah, I'm really impressed by Towson. I sent them a message asking them to come on board on one of my gigs soon. So it's quite exciting. I love his voice. It's very enchanting, isn't it?
Yeah, Nick Martin. Shall we go with a song by Towson? Do you want to introduce it?
Yeah, Luke? So this is Towson, Lay Down.
What you want, what you need, don't bury. SRB Radio.